الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا وسيئات اعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. اما بعد، نراجع اولا ما اخذنا في الدرس الماضي. نعم،
بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. So first thing that we do is we revise the previous lesson or the previous things that we took in the previous lesson.
من يذكر لي ماذا أخذنا في الدرس الماضي؟
So who can mention what we studied last lesson?
نعم. أخذنا في الدرس الماضي ماذا؟ والبقية لم يحضروا معنا؟ اتفقنا على أن يعني يشارك الجميع الذين حضروا معنا الدرس الماضي. من دراستنا وصول فتح الله علي. نعم، من يذكر لي فهرسة الأصول الثلاثة؟ قلنا إذا أردنا أن نفهرس أو نقسم الأصول الثلاثة نقسمها ثلاثة أقسام.
So the question is that we mentioned that if you were to make an index for أصول الثلاثة, we said that you could split them into five separate parts. What are the five parts?
So there are five categories of four. That's the four matters, which is Marjushur, Power Lord,
Masail al-Arba.
Masail al-Arba.
Next.
Two active points, quarterly, and the education document. So these are the four matters. The next is
المسائل الثلاثة.
المسائل الثلاثة, three matters.
نعم.
Next after that.
And then why we study Tawheed, which we already mentioned.
لماذا ندرس التوحيد؟ شرح الأصول الثلاثة.
The three principles. Lastly.
والخان. نعم. غير هذا ماذا أخذت؟
Okay, what else do you take? Other benefits.
نعم.
دخلنا إلى المسائل الأربعة وكنا
المسائل الأربعة هي أولاً العلم.
لابد. So the first, for the four important matters, there is mentioning number one, knowledge, that we have to seek knowledge.
ثم.
والعمل.
Then righteous actions.
العمل بالعلم. نعم.
ذكرنا بالنسبة للعمل الحديث عن أول ثلاثة داخل النار.
أول من تسحب بهم النار ثلاثة منهم عالم تعلم العلم ولم يعمل به، وعالم بعلمه لم يعمل، معذب من قبل عباد الوثن.
So the brother mentioned that we mentioned regarding those people who don't act upon their knowledge. That the sheikh mentioned the hadith that there are three people who will be taken or dragged into hellfire. And from what, the first of these three people is the one, the scholar who has sought knowledge but he doesn't act upon his knowledge. And the Shaykh, he added to this the hadith that those people who seek knowledge and they don't act upon their knowledge will be taken to hellfire before those who worship the idols, as is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi
wasallam. نعم. والعمل ولما تتعلم
تعلم عمل ثم يعمل
والدعوة إليه
ثم يدعو
والصبر على طلب العلم والعمل والدعوة.
يصبر أولا على العلم والثاني على العمل والثالث على الدعوة.
So then the fourth matter that the brother mentioned the rewarding is patience. You have to have patience upon seeking knowledge and patience upon righteous actions and then patience upon giving دعوة to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فتح معك وغيرها.
Any other benefits?
نعم.
يعني ثم أخذنا يعني الأقسام الصبر.
So then we took, as the brother mentioned, the different types of patience. So the first type of patience is being patient upon the obedience to Allah. Like being patient upon the five prayers, being patient upon the fasting. So the second type of patience is patience on staying away from disobedience to Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And then the third type of patience is being patient upon the decree of Allah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees upon his slave some type of poverty or illness or loss or calamity, they be patient upon these. These are the three types of patience. Any other benefits?
ما الدليل على المسائل الأربع؟
What is the evidence for the four important principles?
وهي نعم اقرأ نعم فتح وعلك طيب إذا الدليل في سورة العصر هذه على المسائل الأربعة وهذا هو الدرس الأول نعم.
طيب so you said the last question which is what is the evidence for these four matters and the brother recited Surah Al-Asr. So these four important matters or four important principles are contained within Surah Al-Asr.
نعم القسم الثاني هذا هو الدرس الآن إن شاء الله.
So now we've gone to now the lesson which is now the second part of the index that we made.
ما هو القسم الثاني من أقسام هذا المتن المبارك على ما قسمنا.
So what's the second part in the index of this book? He says that it can be divided into five parts.
Three
matters,
principles.
المسائل الثلاث.
Three important principles or the three important matters.
هل المسائل الثلاث هي الأصول الثلاث؟
So are the three important principles, are they the three principles, the three questions of the grave?
لا.
No.
المسائل الثلاث غير الأصول الثلاث. الأصول الثلاث أخذنا. هي باختصار أسئلة القبر وتأتي بإذن الله تعالى. نعم.
So we've taken the three principles. Which are the questions in the grave? Who is your Lord? Who is this man, the Prophet? And what is your religion? However, the three matters, the Masail al-Thalath, they're separate. I'm going to take that now.
طيب. قبل أن نبدأ في الدرس، لابد أن نعرف التوحيد. من يعرف تعريف التوحيد عند أهل السنة والجماعة؟
So before we
تعريف التوحيد شرعاً.
Before we go into today's lesson, we have to first understand the definition of التوحيد. So who amongst you knows the definition of At-Tawheed according to Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah?
Subhanallah. لو يسألك إنسان يقول أنت موحد ماذا تقول؟
So if a person was to ask you, are you موحد? A person of Tawheed, what would you say?
يقول ما هو التوحيد هذا الذي تدعي؟ عرف لي التوحيد.
So then if he said to you, okay, what is the Tawheed that you say you're upon?
كيف أكون موحد؟
How can I be a موحد؟ What would you say؟
إذا لا تعرف التوحيد وتدعى أنك موحد فأنت لست موحد
أصلا. So if you don't know the definition of توحيد and yet you're claiming that you're موحد, a person of توحيد, then it's not true statement that you're making.
نعم. فأخوانا هذا أهم ما عليك معرفة التوحيد.
So our brothers, the most important thing which is upon you is to know the meaning and the definition of
Tawheed.
If the Muslim isn't going to memorize or know the definition of Tawheed, then who's going to learn it? The disbeliever? So this is what we previously mentioned. Remember when the Sheikh was mentioning, if somebody comes to you and says, why should we study Tawheed? You say to that person, are you a Mu'ahid? Are you a person of Tawheed? He'd say yes. So then you say to him, okay, explain us what you mean by Tawheed. So it's important.
التوحيد شرعاً هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما اختص به من الربوبية. والألوهية والأسماء والصفات. نعم.
So therefore the meaning of التوحيد according to the Sharia is to single out Allah in every single aspect or every single matter that is specific to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether that relates to Ar-Rububiyya or Uluhiyya or Asma wa Safat. And the Shaykh is going to explain these three terms. So who can repeat the definition of Tawheed according to Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah? Who can repeat it? Said, the rest of you don't know the meaning of Tawheed?
هل أنتم على التوحيد أو على الشرك؟ ونحن التوحيد. قال اشرحوا لنا هذا التوحيد.
If now a non-Muslim or a disbeliever comes into the masjid and he says to you, are you people of Tawheed or are you people of shirk? And you say we're people of Tawheed. He then says to you, okay, explain to me a Tawheed. So you have to all know the meaning of a Tawheed.
نعم. التوحيد شرعا. إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما يختص به من الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات.
To single out Allah in everything which is specific to Him. In ربوبية and ألوهية and أسماء والصفات.
لا بد أن نحفظ التعاريف كما ذكرها العلماء. ما نترك من التعريف شيء.
So we have to memorize the definitions of التوحيد. Just as the scholars have mentioned, it's not correct for us to leave bits of the definition out.
نعم. هذا معنى أن التوحيد ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام: توحيد الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات.
So this is the meaning of when we say that توحيد can be split into three categories: either توحيد الربوبية، ألوهية، أسماء والصفات.
فتوحيد الربوبية.
So as for توحيد الربوبية.
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعاله.
It is to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all of His actions.
أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالخلق والملك والتدبير.
Or that we single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that He is the one who is al-Rabb, i.e. the Lord. He is the one who is al-Khaliq, the Creator. And He is the only one who is Mudabbir al-Amr, that He controls all the affairs of the universe. This is Tawheed al-Rububiyya.
Tawheed al-Rububiyya. هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعاله أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالخلق والملك والتدبير.
So again, just so you memorize, توحيد الربوبية is to single out Allah in all of His actions, or we can say, single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى that He is the only Rabb, the Lord, the only Khaliq, the Creator, or the one who controls the affairs of the universe.
الثاني توحيد الألوهية.
Secondly, توحيد الألوهية.
أو توحيد العبودية أو توحيد العبادة.
Or you can say توحيد العبودية. Or you can say توحيد العبادة. You can say any of these three things.
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة.
So this is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in your worship.
أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعال العباد.
Or to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in your actions of worship as a slave to Him.
الصلاة والصيام والحج والزكاة والرغبة والرهبة والخشوع كل العبادة لله.
So for example, prayer, الصلاة, fasting, Hajj, and also الرغبة, which is desiring Allah سبحانه وتعالى, الرهبة, fearing Allah, الخشوع, humility, all of these are types of worship, and therefore we have to single them out purely for the sake of Allah.
تعريف توحيد الأسماء والصفات.
And then the definition of توحيد الأسماء والصفات.
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما سمى وصف به نفسه.
It is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in every single name He has given Himself, or every single description or attribute or characteristic that He has given Himself.
في كتابه أو على لسان رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Either in His book Al-Quran or upon the tongue of His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وذلك بإثبات ما أثبت لنفسه. هذا أعطيني شو
موبايل.
نعم.
We agree that nothing you hear, but if we see anybody playing the mobile, it gets taken. Anybody seen writing with a pen, the pen gets taken.
جزاك الله خير. نعم.
So he said توحيد الأسماء والصفات.
هو.
It is.
إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما سمى وصف به نفسه.
Is to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything, or in every name which He has named for Himself, or in every attribute which He has given to Himself.
في كتابه أو على لسان رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Either in the Quran or on the tongue of His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وذلك بإثبات ما أثبت لنفسه.
And that is by affirming everything which Allah affirmed for Himself.
ونفي ما نفى عن نفسه.
Or negating everything which Allah has negated from Himself.
من غير تحريف ولا تعطيل.
And that is without performing a tahrif. And the meaning of tahrif is to change the wording from what Allah has mentioned. Or a ta'til. And a ta'til means to negate the meaning or to interpret the meaning wrongly.
غير تحريف ولا تعطيل وغير تكييف ولا تمثيل.
And without performing a takif. And takif is
يسأل عن الكيفية كما قال الرحمن عرش استوى قال كيف استوى.
So the meaning of a takif is to question about the attributes. So for example, when Allah says in the Quran الرحمن على العرش استوى, Allah الرحمن the most merciful is established over His throne. A person would say, how is He established over His throne?
So
you're questioning how is the attribute of Allah, and this is not allowed in Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat.
وَلَا تَمْثِيلِ.
And simply a tamthil, which is equating the attribute of Allah to the attribute of creation.
يعني تمثيل الله سبحانه وتعالى بخلقه.
So for example, equating Allah to His creation, even though Allah is more high and more elevated than His creation.
من يذكر لي تعريف التوحيد وتعريف أنواع التوحيد الثلاثة عندنا السنة والجماعة.
So who can mention now from amongst you the definition of a tawheed with Ahl Sunnah and the definition of the three categories of tawheed according to Ahl Sunnah?
من يعرف؟
Who knows?
فقط بقي ما عرف التوحيد.
Only three or four people. Nobody else knows the tawheed.
من يدرس التوحيد إذا أهل الكفر؟
Who's going to study tawheed? The people of disbelief.
إخوانا هذا أهم ما عليك. نحن الآن ندرس في الدورة هذه الدورة ما هو معلوم من الدين بالضرورة.
Said our brothers, this is the most important thing that is an obligation upon you to study. We're studying in this دورة these lessons that we should be known by necessity.
نعم لا نعلم شيء نافل. هذا أوجب الواجبات عليك.
The Sheikh isn't teaching something which is voluntary, something which is surplus requirements. This is the biggest and most obligatory of types of knowledge upon you.
نعم. من يعرف للتوحيد شرعا.
So who can define a tawheed according to the Sharia?
التوحيد شرعا. لا حول ولا قوة. طيب. نعم.
إفراد الله باللباس.
ليس باللباس.
على التوحيد شرعا إفراد. وعلى التوحيد شرعا إفراد الله بالعبادة والأفعال.
من يعرف للتوحيد شرعا. نعم.
توحيد شرعا إفراد الله بما يختص به
من
عبادة
من
الربوبية
قلنا الربوبية وألوهية وأسماء وصفات.
ما نتكلم.
Who gave that answer?
It's me.
بسم الله أوكي. تفضل.
إفراد الله إفراد الله بما اختص به من الربوبية والألوهية وبأسماء بأسماء والصفات.
فتح الله عليك. الذي يعني يوجه للسؤال هو يتكلم.
شكرا.
نعم.
أريد أن أساعده.
توحيد ما في مساعدة. يسأل وحده في قبره.
You said you can't help anybody about توحيد. In the grave you'll be asked alone.
نعم. إذن التوحيد شرعاً. وإفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما اختص به من الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات.
So therefore, التوحيد according to the Sharia is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in every single matter which is specific to Him, in His ربوبية, in Him, in His worship, and ألوهية and أسماء والصفات.
من يعرف لي توحيد الربوبية؟
So who can define توحيد الربوبية؟
توحيد الربوبية. نعم.
Tawheed al-Rububiyya is slinging Allah alone in His Lordship from everything that He's described for Himself and Slinging that alone in his lordship, and everything he describes, and they know it from the thing. Basically,
إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعاله أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالخلق والملك والتدبير.
It's to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in His actions, or we can say it's to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى Him being the Creator and being the one who is the Lord al-Rabb, or the one who controls the affairs. That's توحيد الربوبية.
توحيد الألوهية.
توحيد الألوهية.
أو توحيد العبادة أو توحيد العبودية.
Or any of those three terms. ألوهية أو عبادة أو عبودية.
نعم. نعم. إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة أو بأفعال العباد.
It is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in worship, or to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in your actions of worship.
توحيد الأسماء والصفات.
توحيد الأسماء والصفات names and attributes.
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما سمى وصف به نفسه في كتابه أو على لسان رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
It is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in every name which he has given himself, or every attribute which he has given himself, either in the Quran or upon the tongue of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
وذلك بإثبات ما أثبت لنفسه ونفي ما نفى عن نفسه.
And that is by affirming everything which he has affirmed for himself and negating everything which he has negated away from himself.
من غير تحريف ولا تعطيل ولا تكييف ولا تمثيل.
Thus without التحريف, i.e. changing the wording, or التعطيل, I falsely interpreting the meanings of names and attributes of Allah, or without takif, questioning how the attribute is, or without tamthil, I giving an example of creating the attribute of Allah to the attribute of creation. So now, the lesson now is in the second chapter, the second part of أصول الثلاثة. Therefore, what is the second part of the index that we made earlier on?
ذكرنا الآن. نعم. ما هو القسم الثاني؟ ما هو القسم الثاني؟
What's the second type of meaning? The second chapter, the second chapter from the five chapters that we made.
The first one was why we studied Tajweed.
No.
Now.
ثلاثة مسائل.
المسائل الثلاث.
The three principles.
والمسائل الثلاثة قلنا هي غير الأصول الثلاث.
And we said that these three matters are different to the three important principles, the three questions.
المسائل الثلاثة باختصار.
So the three principles or the three important matters that we're talking about now in summary are.
المسألة الأولى إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالربوبية وبالأسماء والصفات.
The first matter from these three important matters is singling out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in الربوبية, in His lordship, and in أسماء والصفات, His names and His attributes. That's the first matter.
المسألة الثانية.
The second matter is
إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة.
Singling out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in your worship.
المسألة الثالثة.
And the third important matter from these three.
البراءة من الشرك وأهله.
Is disassociating yourself from a shirk and the people of shirk. Jinn, when they used to come to the sittings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did they used to say?
ماذا قال؟ فلما حضروه قالوا
أنصتوا.
So when they came or they were present, they said أنصتوا, be silent, be quiet.
جبريل عليه السلام في مجلس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تكلم
جبريل عليه السلام when he came and he sat in the gatherings of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did he ever speak
جلس
he sat
ومد رجليه ولا جلس جلسة المتعلم المتأدب
so when جبريل عليه السلام when he came and he sat in the gatherings of, with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did he sit extending his legs like this no he sat as a student learning and being serious with manners
نعم طيب إذا ما هي المسائل الثلاث الآن ذكرناها باختصار.
So therefore, what are the three matters which the Sheikh just mentioned? I'll summarizing.
من يعيد علي؟
Who can repeat them?
المسائل الثلاث باختصار.
In summary, three matters.
المسألة الأولى إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالربوبية وبالأسماء والصفات.
The first important matter is singing out Allah in ربوبية أسماء وصفات.
المسألة الثانية إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة.
Second matter is singing out Allah in the act of worship.
المسألة الثالثة البراءة من الشرك وأهله.
And the third important matter is disassociating yourself from shirk and the people of shirk.
المسألة الأولى إفراد الله بالربوبية والأسماء والصفات.
So the first important matter is singing out Allah in the ربوبية and أسماء والصفات.
المسألة الثانية إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة والعبودية.
Second, singing out Allah in عبودية in worship.
المسألة الثالثة البراءة من الشرك وأهله.
And thirdly, the third matter is disassociating yourself from shirk and the people of shirk.
كيف تكون البراءة من الشرك وأهله؟
So how should a person disassociate himself from shirk and the people of shirk? How is this disassociation? How should it be?
من يعرف؟ كيف نبرأ من الشرك وأهله؟ كيف تبرأ من الشرك وأهله؟
How do you free yourself from shirk and his people? Who knows?
تبرأ من الشرك وأهله بأمور ثلاث.
You free yourself or dissociate yourself from a shirk and the people of shirk in three ways or through three matters.
بالقلب.
Number one, in your heart.
وباللسان.
Number two, upon your tongue.
وبالجوارح.
And number three, upon your limbs.
بالقلب واللسان والجوارح.
In your heart and upon your tongue and upon your limbs.
البراءة من الشرك وأهله تكون بالقلب واللسان والجوارح.
Disassociating and freeing yourself from a shirk and the people of shirk is done through one's heart, tongue and limbs.
بالقلب.
Upon the heart.
تبغض الكفار وعيادة واحتفالات المطقوسة والشركيات البدع.
Number one, you hate the disbelievers. You hate the gatherings, the celebrations, the festivals that are specific to them.
باللسان إنني براء مما تعبدون.
Upon your tongue, إنني بريء مما تعبدون. I am free. I disassociate myself from that which you worship. Upon your tongue.
ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم.
And I do not worship that which you worship, and neither do you worship which I worship. Upon your tongue.
بالجوارح.
And also in terms of actions upon your limbs.
عدم مخالطة الكفار في أعيادهم واحتفالاتهم وطقوسهم.
And that is by not partaking with the disbelievers. In terms of their festivals and celebrations and things which are specific to them.
أو يلبس لباس الكفار.
Or wearing the clothing of the disbelievers.
أو القصات قصات الشعر.
Or how or the haircuts or the ways that they cut their hair.
أو ينظر إليهم نظرة إعجاب.
Or even looking at the disbelievers and being amazed by them.
كالنظر للمصارع الحرة.
Like look.
مصارع. مصارع.
Like watching wrestling.
أو أفلام الغربية.
Or even Western films.
أو كأس العالم.
Or watching the World Cup.
نعم. الكافر عدو لمن؟
نعم. The kafir, the disbeliever, he's an enemy to whom?
من يعلم؟ يعني؟ الكافر عدو لمن؟ ما حد يتكلم. نعم. عدو لله. فتح الله عليك.
The kafir, the disbeliever, is an enemy to Allah.
كيف يكون عدو لله وأنت تنظر إليه نظرة إعجاب؟
So how can this person, this disbeliever, be an enemy to Allah, and yet you look at this person, you're amazed by him and his actions?
لكن لابد أن نفرق بين الدعوة إلى الله وبين الإعجاب بالكافر والولاء والبراء.
But we have to differentiate between when we're calling to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. And when we're freeing ourselves from the disbelievers in terms of being amazed at their actions.
فمن حيث البراءة من الشرك وأهله لابد أن تبرأ من الشرك وأهله.
So in terms of freeing yourself from shirk and the people of shirk, this is an obligation upon you. You have to free yourself from them.
لكن هل معنى هذا أن تضرب الكافر؟
But does this mean that you start hitting the disbeliever?
تتعدى عليه؟
Or you take away his rights and oppress him?
لا, هذا باب التعامل أمر آخر.
So these are two different separate things. One thing is interacting with the disbelievers, باب التعامل, how we interact with them. And the other separate thing is in terms of freeing yourself from their actions, the shirk and the people of shirk. So an example of this is, so there's a person, a Muslim, and his father, and we ask Allah for safety and pardon, he is a kafir, a disbeliever. So now how does this Muslim child, what should he do, or how does he react with and interact with his non-Muslim father? So now this Muslim child is for him to love his father with a natural form of love, just like any child loves his father. But at the same time, he hates him for the sake of Allah because he's a disbeliever. So at the same time, this Muslim child, he has within him love, which is natural between a son and his father, and at the same time, hatred for the sake of Allah.
نعم هذا هو الدرس الثاني.
So this is the second lesson.
من يعيد علي ما أخذنا في هذا الدرس.
So who can now repeat the benefits of what we've taken in this lesson?
نعم. والبقية لم يحضر. نعم. البقية ما
يحضر. The rest of you, were you not present? Were you not listening?
جدران.
Walls.
أنا ما أكلم جدران.
I'm not speaking to walls.
من يعرف؟
Who knows?
أي فائدة أخذناها
من any benefit we've taken from this lesson, any benefit.
نعم.
هذا الدرس.
نعم.
المسائل الثلاث.
هذا الدرس كان في المسائل الثلاث.
So this lesson is the three principles, the three important matters.
هل المسائل الثلاث هي الأصول الثلاث؟ لا, الأصول الثلاث هي أسئلة القلب.
نعم. The three principles, the أصول الثلاث, are the three questions of the grave. These three matters are different to this.
So
the first important matter is singing out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ar-rububiyyah, in His Lordship and asma wa sifat. That's the first important matter.
إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعباد.
To single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in worship.
الثالث البراءة من الشرك.
And the third matter is freeing yourself and disassociating yourself from shirk and the people of shirk.
نعم فتح الله عليك. كيف تكون البراءة من الشرك وأهله؟
How does a person free himself from shirk and the people of shirk?
نعم.
بالقلب.
With one's heart.
والجوارح.
And upon one's tongue and upon one's limbs.
والجوارح. فتح الله عليك. نعم. طيب. وعرفنا التوحيد شرعا.
And we defined the meaning of التوحيد according to the Sharia.
وعرفنا نوع التوحيد الثلاث.
And we also defined the three types of التوحيد.
بعد هذا القسم الثالث. ما هو القسم الثالث؟
After this, now the third chapter of Usul al-Thalatha. What is the third chapter?
نعم.
Or the third categorization?
القسم الثالث. نعم.
لماذا ندرس التوحيد؟
لماذا ندرس التوحيد؟
Why do we study توحيد? This is what we're going to talk about now.
نعم. لو قال لك إنسان لماذا ندرس التوحيد؟
So if a person came to you and he said, why do we study التوحيد?
لماذا ندرس التوحيد؟ نعم.
Understand to be aware of the oneness of Allah.
حق الله العبيد.
Because number one, it is a right of Allah upon the slave.
لا يدخل الجنة إلا موحد.
Because nobody will enter into Jannah except if he is a person of التوحيد.
لا يقبل الله سبحانه وتعالى أي عمل إلا بالتوحيد.
Because Allah does not accept any action if it is not based on التوحيد.
استقرار الأمن والهداية والطمأنينة حلاوة الإيمان.
Because safety and security and guidance and also feeling or tasting the sweetness of iman, only comes through at Tawheed.
حتى لا نقع في الشرك.
And also so that we don't fall into shirk.
نعم. ضع هذا جانبه.
Just leave the book there.
وقرب علينا
خلينا. يا أخي يا أخي. ها؟ أنا أستني يا أخي.
ها؟
نعم. سيدي سنوك بدك مجلس. ها؟ بإيه كلا
تقدم
كم يا أخي.
التفرق هذا قال عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه من عمل الشيطان.
He said this type of separation, being far away, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that this is from the acts of shaitan. Do you want to act like the acts of shaitan? If you want to do so, then you can stay far away. So therefore now the third part of Usul al-Thalatha is, of this text is, why do we study at-Tawheed?
قال المؤلف رحمه الله اعلم ارشدك الله لطاعتي.
The author Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab he said اعلم know may Allah guide you to the truth or to his obedience.
أن الحنيفية ملة إبراهيم.
That الحنيفية this term الحنيفية.
ما هي الحنيفية؟
So what is الحنيفية؟
الحنيفية هي الملة المائلة عن الشرك المبنية على الإخلاص والتوحيد الملة المائلة عن الشرك ترجع دائما للتوحيد ولا يخرج إلى الشرك. يبني هذا الأمر على الإخلاص والتوحيد لله سبحانه وتعالى.
So therefore, the Sheikh asked, "What is al-Hanifiya? Al-Hanifiya is that path which leads you away from al-Shirk and towards al-Tawheed. So therefore, it's built upon staying away from Shirk and bringing you closer to al-Tawheed. This is al-Hanifiya, the path of Ibrahim.
إذن al-Hanifiya. هي الملة المائلة عن الشرك المبنية على الإخلاص والتوحيد.
So, الحنيفية is الملة the path المائلة عن الشرك which is away from الشرك المبني and is built upon الإخلاص sincerity and التوحيد
هي أن تعبد الله مخلصا له الدين
that you worship Allah making all of your acts of worship sincerely for him
الله سبحانه وتعالى خلق الخلق ليعبده
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created all of creation so that they may worship Him.
ما هو الدليل أن الله سبحانه وتعالى خلق الخلق ليعبده؟
What is the evidence that Allah only created creation in order to worship Him? What is the evidence?
من يعلم؟
Who knows?
نعم.
اسم الذاريات وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. فتح الله عليك.
The ayah that the brother quoted in Surah الذاريات.
طيب لو دخل عندنا رجل الى المسجد
okay so now if a person enters upon us into the masjid
ومع كرة وصافرة
and he has a ball and a whistle
ودخل الى المسجد هنا يريد يلعب كرة هنا
and he enters into the masjid and he wants to play football here in the masjid
ماذا نقول عنه
what will we say about him
ماذا نقول عنه
What do we say? What would we say about him?
مجنون.
فنقول له.
مجنون. نعم.
مجنون.
We say that he's insane. This person's insane.
لأنه لا يعرف أن هذا مكان للعبادة للصلاة ليس مكان للعب الكرة.
Because this person he doesn't know that this place is for worshiping of Allah and this place isn't for playing football or playing with Allah.
أخذ الإنسان هذا الجهاز.
A person takes this machine, the mobile phone, this device.
وأخذ يحفر به الأرض.
And then he starts digging the earth with this mobile phone.
ماذا نقول عنه؟
What would you say about him?
مجنون.
مجنون.
Say he's insane.
طيب. أنت الآن خلقت.
Okay, so now you yourself, you have been created.
حتى تأكل وتلعب وتشرب وتنام.
So you can eat and drink and sleep. Is that why you were created?
لا.
No.
خلقت حتى تعبد الله.
You were created so that you would worship Allah.
فإذا اشتغلت في هذه الدنيا بغير العبادة فأنت مجنون.
So therefore, if you preoccupy your time in other than worshiping Allah in this world, then you are مجنون. You are insane.
مثل الذي يحفر الأرض بهذا الجهاز.
Just like the one who uses a mobile phone to start digging in the earth.
هذا ما يعرف أن هذا ليس لحفر الأرض.
Because this person, he doesn't know that this device is not used for digging the earth.
وأنت لم تخلق للأكل والشرب.
And simply, you were not created for eating and drinking and sleeping.
نعم. خلقت لغاية وهي العبادة.
نعم. You were created for a particular objective, and that is to worship Allah.
ولهذا إذا اشتغلت في هذه الدنيا بالعبادة سعيد.
And therefore, if you occupy your time in this world in worshiping Allah, then you have achieved success, or you are happy.
وإذا تركت العبادة.
But if you leave alone worship.
نسأل الله السلامة والعافية.
And we ask Allah for pardon and safety.
كان الشقاء.
Then it is only being miser or wretched or sadness, الشقاء.
ولهذا ولله الحمد.
And therefore, and due to this, and all praises due to Allah.
لا تسمع أن مسلم انتحر في مسجد من المساجد.
And for this reason, you'll never find, you'll never hear that a Muslim committed suicide in a mosque.
نعم. لأن الأماكن هذه بنيت للعبادة، فعندما تعبد الله ترتاح.
And this is because that these places, the mosques, they have been built in order to worship Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. So when you come to this type of place and you worship Allah, you feel comfortable, you feel nice and happy inside.
وتسمع ملايين.
But on the other hand, you hear millions of people.
تحل في أماكن يدعي هؤلاء أنها أماكن للراحة النفسية.
You hear millions of people committing suicide in other places, which people claim that these are the places where you find comfort and happiness and delight.
عند البحار.
Near oceans or seaside.
أو أماكن يعني تجمعهم للخمور والرقص وكذا.
Or in pubs and nightclubs and discos.
لماذا؟
Why?
لأنهم سخروا البدن في غير مكلفة.
Because they're trying to use or force their body to do something for which it wasn't created to do.
إذن السعادة في عبادة الله.
And therefore happiness and true happiness is in worshipping Allah Subhanahu wa Taala.
ولكن التقي هو السعيد.
As the poet said, ولكن التقي هو السعيد. That the one who has taqwa, he is the one who is happy.
إذن كل واحد منا يعرف أن خلق حتى يكون عابد لله.
So therefore now every single one amongst us knows that he was created in order for him to be a slave and a worshipper of Allah.
لكن الإشكال في أن تعمل على هذا، على أن تكون عابد لله في هذه الدنيا.
But the problem now occurs in trying to implement and acting upon the knowledge that you are a slave and a worshipper of Allah in this world.
وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
I did not create a jinn and ins, mankind, except that they should worship me, as Allah says.
طيب. ثم عن المؤلف رحمه الله.
Then after this, the author, may Allah bless upon him.
أخذ يذكر أسئلة حتى يعلم الطالب إذا سُمِل كيف يجيب.
So then after this, the author started mentioning certain questions. So that if a person is asked these questions, you know how to answer them.
وهذا هو القسم الرابع من أقسام هذا المثنى المبارك، مثنى سورة الثلاثة.
So now this is the fourth section of this blessed book or this blessed treatise of سورة الثلاثة.
نأخذ ربع ساعة تقريبا تكتب فيها ما أخذنا من فوائد ثم بعد هذا نبدأ.
So now we're going to take 15 minutes. Like before, like the first lesson, sit in groups like you are, take down, revise, take down the notes, memorize them, and then we come back for the next lesson. Without raising your voices, or leaving the masjid, or talking about worldly affairs, just to your lesson. These mosques are whose houses? For Allah. So don't call or worship anybody besides Allah. Don't supplicate to anybody besides Allah.
Allahumma wa sallallahu alaihi wa sallam.